Finally, the last video about the 86 are here. Yeah, sorry for long time no see, if I can say it like that. We will do landing gear, decals, and a bit weathering. I have decided to not finish that this year. We will see how that covering is holding up, and so I do trim tabs, yeah, and we will get that engine to run on gas, because with the prices and everything now, we have to save where we can save. So the big question is if we can get that engine to run good on gas. And we'll do baffling in the cowling, and I will explain that and why that is so important to do when we run gas engines, fuel engines with glow fuel, methanol and oil. It's a lot of lubricant and a lot of fuel going through the engine, so it's very rare that it's a problem with cooling. But running on gas, it's a big issue. So we will start with the landing gear. Yeah, so we will do some bending and cutting and heating and lot of things. So we need this. I always have to look for them. They always end up there. I don't know why. Yeah, we start with that. Who can see? Oh yeah, it looks much better. Strong. Oh. Supposed to be mounted like that, but sail retracts on this 86 will be mounted there, and we have to have a steel bend tube going there, mounted there. So I made this, and I clamped this in the vise, and this will be the tubes, and I just heat it up, put it in there, and bend it around the radius here. So we'll see if that works. Thank you.
Yeah, now we are in the final stages here. Maybe you noticed something behind me. I cleaned up a bit. I used 2 days in the Easter rearrange and do some cleaning in the hub room. Actually, for some hours, it smells like soap in here. Scary. And but the coffee machine. I cleaned that also with that cleaner thing you have. And the things that come out of that, I think maybe I could run my car on that. It looks same as something. Anyhow, final stages on the 86. And my good friend Alf printed this to me. And this will be part of the baffling to the engine. And you see that video about the engine. So now I don't have to go bankrupt with the glow fuel running that engine. So we will do this baffling and things to get this to be correct. Yeah, we do that.
When we have this expertly round hole there, and we draw air from the engine. This engine is also a vacuumer. You have to think about that. Air go in there from inside there. There. So the last thing we do before we mount this engine is to, with the compressor air, blow out things, because I actually have been part of that. Not my engine and my airplane, but friend I had lost compression on one cylinder. That was actually debris, wood debris, go in and stick to the valve inside there. So we have to think about that. But now we have to mount the engine correct and take measurements of that. We know we have center about this baffling. Follow closely now. Yeah, and you back there that is not listening. Hello?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And do you see? Yeah, you see? Here we will search for the highest point, or with the room, the point with the most room. And we will try to copy that over to this balsa. So if you take that there, and we make the radius. About so, then we go there, it's flat. Up a bit there, but I think I want to take away that first. Hold on. Then we can, now it's lower. No, you don't see my hand is in the way. Here. It's that we have to copy now. Let me see here. It's the highest point now. So then we just take about that. And now, same here. Here, and we can see that we missing something here. Take that away. So, and now I see that I have take away too much there, but we are in here. We need to take away small steps. I think we can call that good enough. Agree, and we need a bit more room here. Like so, and this is on the middle of the cylinder, and what we want, all the air that comes in this have to be forced through the cooling fins on the cylinders. Yeah, then we are at in the next day, and I made this special tool. Yeah, because we want to make the radius of that baffle plate, and scissors. Why use knife on balsa? And of course we have to hit the top of the cowling, so roughly there, and we can put this in here. See, no more, of course. Need more. Now it starts to happen things here. Yeah. Yeah. Then we know the height. Then we just yeah. Oh, I got it. Yeah. You remember this? Yeah. Height there. And then I just take off the cowling and use that as a guide for the, of course I marked it inside so I know where it should be, but now we're going, no, yeah, and I just take off the screws so we can do like this, of course. Ay, 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 ay. Should have started with stamps instead. Oh. Yeah, first scratch. We are on the tight side here. That's good. Yeah. And I think maybe we should take it off again and just take away a bit on the top. These three holes are for just some air into the exhaust, because it will be hot, so just to have some airflow through that.
Yeah, and then we put in the dummy engine also. It could be better, but you know, if you think like this, you so when you walk past and you see, oh, that was a nice Moki. We glue in the dummy engine also. So now we can just do like this.
Then we finished. Almost. Just tiny touch-ups and some things. I have to check the engine if that works okay. Some adjustments, I think. And I think we do a flying video also. You can see how that turned out. And you remember these guys. Yeah. The Bee Gees staying alive. No, not staying alive. Now we have Steve, the angry pilot. So now we're going to fly this and have done all the digital things and now it's just some setup with fine tuning of the radio and things. So that's oh shit! Yeah, this Spitfire. See you in the next video. I guess I deserve that. Yeah.